I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey Blackhawks, I'm Raina Steffen.
And I'm Troy Jansen.
Welcome to the first ever edition of our brand new William Steele News program.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Blackhawk Buzz.
Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. Did I get delivered here? Somebody tell me, please. This whole world confusing me.
If you're planning on taking someone from another school to homecoming, guest passes are due to the front office September 9th.
We know that you guys are all excited for homecoming this year because City of Lights is going to be the best yet.
Jake Bailey and Stuart Delaney grinded gears this week with the Robotics Club. Here's what they have to showcase.
Robotics Club is an engaging activity where students can have fun with robots in competition.
What got me interested in robotics was I just love building stuff and just taking things apart and putting it back together, and when I heard about it, I just was so interested into it.
Robotics Club started as an idea. It was something that I was excited about. Two summers ago, I went to a AZ Science conference and learned more about the robotics field and how many schools have a club, and it was something I was excited about starting at Williamsfield High School.
Typically, we would set up our robot and we basically mess around with the programs, see what works, see what didn't, plug in some controllers, see if the robot will move or go forward or backward to see if the arm will work.
The Robotics Club meets to have competitions with other schools for whose robot is best.
Before the competition starts, the students are given a task that their robots have to do. And in order for them to succeed, their robot needs to do a certain amount of things and needs to be programmed to do those things. They work with teams and work together to make sure that the robot completes these tasks, and if the teams do well, they move on.
The Robotics Club meets after school on Wednesdays in room 312.
Join Robotics Club, it's really fun. You know, it has a lot of fun people.
This is Jake Bailey and Stuart Delaney reporting for the Blackhawk Buzz. Now back to the studio.
Dixie State University is coming on September 9th, and there's a personal statement workshop on September 10th for anyone looking to work on their college applications. Make sure you attend.
Freshmen that are in need of tutoring, Link Crew is sponsoring tutoring all week long in the library during A lunch and B lunch and after school in room 249.
Now, as a special request from Dr. Wadawa and fulfilled by our own Raven Lynn and Aaron Tucker, here's an announcement on trash around campus.
I'm not picking that up. What a waste of time.
Do it!
Shia, what are you doing here?
Don't let your dreams be dreams. Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come true! Some people dream of success while you're gonna wake up and work hard at it. Nothing is impossible. And you're not gonna stop there. No! What are you waiting for? Do it! Just do it! Yes, you can! Just do it! If you're tired of starting over, stop giving up.
I've seen the wrongs of my ways. I want to change. I need to fix this.
Set crew for the fall musical Beauty and the Beast needs help Fridays from 3 to 6 and Saturdays from 8 to 3. Any experience with power tools or painting would be appreciated.
Miss B wants you to work on scholarships and rack up those community service hours.
Now here's Houston Gray and Robert Dunn with our sports report.
It was a busy week for Blackhawk sports this week, and here's this week's recap.
Williamsfield defeated Campo Verde 16-2 in what was a great opening for our Blackhawk football defense.
Williamsfield Golf finished in fourth place out of 18 teams in their tournament last week.
For upcoming events, Williamsfield football is away at Desert Vista tonight.
Cross country is away at Poston Butte for their second meet of the season next Wednesday.
Finally, girls volleyball has an away game at Tulsa Union next Tuesday.
Fall sports are now in full swing, ready to dominate and show what our school is made of. Here at the studios, we had the opportunity to interview the mastermind behind our varsity football team.
The expectations are always kind of set by the players, not so much us. Our expectations is that they come to practice, they work hard every day, and they do the best they can to put them in positions to be successful. There's certain things we can't control, so all we do is worry about controlling the things we can and try and become a better football team every single day. All the rankings were two in the state in our division, so Worlds 1 were two, eighth in the state in all divisions and stuff like that. So, and you know, our concern right now is Campbell. That's our first game, and that's all that matters. The Higley game, I don't even know when it is on the schedule. It's 5 or 6 or somewhere around there. We've got to take care of Campbell first.
Here's Devin Goff with some spooky conspiracies about our school.
Williamsfield High School, a school best known for its efforts and achievements in the athletic field, behind the scenes to all its lives within the locker room. Both students and athletes can be found using them, but an unfortunate factor lies inside these rooms. Theft, which occurs inevitably. Most factors and ideas are to blame. We've caught up with a couple of students who share the same testimony as those who's to blame.
I've never had anything stolen from my locker. Keeping things in their lockers overnights for weeks and they get stolen. Yeah, many people have had that problem. What
problem? Could their speculations be true or just rumor? Another student concludes the same speculation.
I usually go inside the locker room in the mornings because I got weights first hour. I've witnessed a little bit of suspicious stuff going on that has to do with administration. Like I've seen coaches looking through other students' lockers for some reason. I don't think they have any right to do that.
Whether or not these ideas are correct, a more viable idea is just common student-on-student theft. Underlining to this, it's best to avoid by locking your bag up and leaving unnecessary valuables at home.
This has been Campus Conspiracies, reporting back to the studio.
Thanks for watching, Blackhawks. From here in the studio, I'm Raina Steffen.
And I'm Troy Jansen.
Have an awesome day.